Thank you, Bunny. Today we dragged some our great speakers for five speakers from Japan. This session will focus on open innovation, including government-funded multi-sector R&D projects in Japan for production and quality control of human ES-iPS cells. The speakers will provide the latest information on mass production technology and several global market products of assay kit and equipment for quality control of stem cells. First speaker is Norio Nakatsuji, professor and founding director of WPI iStems Kyoto University. He will talk about multidisciplinary research of human pluripotent stem cells, including novel 3D culture system for large-scale production and application, and also chemical control of cardiomyocyte differentiation. Professor Nakatsuji, please.
Welcome to the so-called Japan session, but we are not representing all of Japan, but some showcase at Kyoto University of academia industry collaboration. That's, I think, key issue to make the sustainable practical application in near future. Okay. This session and my activity is focusing on the to make safe and effective stem cell therapy to many patients at affordable cost. For that, the key word is large scale production and high quality stem cells and differentiated cells and robustness and reliability and low cost. So for that, one issue is multidisciplinary technology, including chemical compound and functional materials. And also, the player should be not only scientists doing research, but engineers and particularly industry sector. So I have been leading this excellent team of academic scientists and eight companies. So Japanese companies are widely known that for their reliability and quality control of their technology. So I like best make best use of their technology and system to realize well-controlled device and production system for stem cells and cell therapy. So those companies, four of them will give a presentation after me. So I focus on the our own research, collaborating with companies of two issues. So first is large-scale production using new three-dimensional culture system. And next is differentiation method. So to use no cytokines, but only chemical compound to enable very reliable, low-cost differentiation method, which is necessary for the real application, particularly in clinical application. Okay, many of you here already realize that we cannot work on culture dish or even flask for the real application of stem cells to cell therapy. So maybe standard typical number of cells we need for treating one patient is 10 to 9. Eye disease is exceptionally need only small number of the cells, so it's starting clinical trial. They need probably 10 to 5, probably, but other heart, liver, spinal cord injury is expected to need 10 to 9. So how to accomplish this scale of cells? So one method, rather middle scale is culture bag system we are using. So this gas permeable culture bag produced by company Nipro, they already produced the automatic culture system of cells attached to the all the inner surface of culture bags. However, we need further scale up. For that, bioreactor is a very attractive system. So, because if we work on adhesion culture, we need surface to attach of high quality. And that limits the scale and need good adhesion molecule. However, there are several attempts worldwide to make three-dimensional suspension culture. However, there are still some problem of spontaneous fusion between the aggregate to induce differentiation or necrosis, and also scaling up. So first, we developed the sphere culture system. So different from the already reported one, our sphere shows perfect sphere with homogeneous size. And this can be propagated continuously. First, their inner structure is a package of the homogeneous cells. And since I'm the cell biologist, I worked a little closer, and we found junctional complex on the surface. So it looks like epiblast sphere is epithelium is rounded up with apical surface on the surface. And we could expand the culture cell number continuously up to, not up to, but we tested only 50 or 55 passages. However, in 1 month, so it's subcultured every 5 days, and in 1 month, it becomes 10 to 4th or 5th expansion, just the same as ordinary conventional adhesion culture. We used tested several human ESL lines and several iPSL lines. We succeeded to all of the cell lines. And however, bioreactor is a very attractive with 100 liter or even 1,000 liter. However, one key problem is it's well known the physical damage caused by shear force is actually killed the cells. Yeah. Some cells survive. So we tested very mild starring. It looks like we got some spheres, but more than half of cells are dying with many cell debris appears. So that's how to reduce the physical force to maintain the suspension is we came up with a new polymer, originally proposed by a company, Nissan Chemical. And this polymer X I can't reveal today because we are submitting a paper. However, that polymer is with very low concentration, like 0.02% or less, can keep the spheres suspended. So you imagine it's because of viscosity or hydrogel formation, but it's not. Viscosity do not increase, and it is not gel. It behave like just liquid, but still spheres or plastic beads even do not sediment to the bottom. So I have no video today. So as a proof of principle, we used 200 milliliter gas permeable bag, and we could grow 2.8 × 10⁸ cells with 200 milliliter gas permeable bag without any agitation, any movement, any anything. Just put on the put inside the CO2 incubator. These cells can grow in this size. So with a similar thickness of the bag, with for example 1 liter bag, we should be able to grow 10⁹ cells in one bag. So it's a single lot production, ideal for the quality control. Okay. The next issue is cell differentiation. So usually differentiation protocol use growth factor, cytokine, because it's working inside our body. However, those cytokines, it's very difficult to get a high quality clinical grade with reasonable cost. So for example, my group calculated simply the how to obtain 10⁹ cardiomyocyte to treat one patient using currently available best protocol using 3 or 4 cytokines. And cost is $0.1 million for only growth differentiation media. That's prohibitory for the sustainable cell therapy. So we try to replace the cytokine by chemical compound, and we started almost 10 years ago by screening the not so large 10,000 chemical library with using a reporter, this case monkey yeast cells integrated with a reliable cardiomyocyte promoter GFP system. And our chemicals work robustly. So robustness is a very important issue in stem cells. You could publish paper, but it's not enough to make useful for the cell therapy. So robustness, our cell compound work for every human yeast cell lines, and monkey, even mouse yeast cells, and iPS cell line from Kyoto, Wisconsin, and Librocell. That's a startup company we founded. And we don't know the detail of the mechanism, but at least that work on very low stream or later stage of wind pathway. Probably it has additional effect. Okay, so with this one, in 3 weeks, we can get to such a beating colony with efficiency of 95% or more. So, and G cells has relatively matured characteristic with gene expression and ion transporter expression, and mostly ventricular cardiomyocyte, and it's good for the application. And it has well-developed leukemia. And so this protocol is published, the paper published in Cell Reports, and Dr. Minami is still improving to the further to increase the efficiency and the simplicity and scale up, like starting from sphere, mass cultured sphere, directly into the cardiospheres. And it's a two-stage differentiation. First stage is using already known 3 chemicals to induce mesoderm lineage. And our then switch to our chemical compound that change those mesoderm cells to the almost pure cardiomyocyte cells. So that's best, we believe it's a currently best method for clinical application, and we are approached by several big hospital and clinical team to collaborate for clinical application. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Thank you, Professor Nakatsuji. Next speaker is Dr. Chikafumi Yokoyama, CEO of Liprocell. He will talk about stem cell business. As you know, Liprocell has received formal approval from the Osaka Stock Exchange for listing on the JASDAQ Market Growth IPO on June this year. Dr. Yokoyama, please.
Thank you for introduction. My name is Chikafumi Yokoyama, CEO of Liprocell. Today, I would like to introduce our activities and our products. Liprocell was founded in year 2003 by professors Nakauchi and Professor Nakatsuji. And we have 10 years experience in this field. This slide shows a relationship with universities and Liprocells. We have a strong relationship with several Japanese top stem cell institute. And our role is to generate and create cutting edge products from the technical seeds created by universities. We are now focusing on two business areas. One is the research, and the second is the drug discoveries. In the research area, we are providing the research reagents such as culture media and freezing media and so on to universities. In the drug discovery business, we are providing the human iPS cell-derived functional cells, including cardiomyocyte, neurons, and hepatocyte to pharmaceutical industries. In the future, we'd like to expand our capability to next generation's medical technology, such as regenerative medicine and personalized medicines. Today, I'd like to introduce a research reagent and drug discovery business. First is research reagents. This is our product lineups of human ES and iPS cells. We have four types of culture media in the center, and primate ES cell medium is one of the most famous culture media in Japan, which was used by Professor Shinya Yamanaka for the first invention of iPS cells. And ReproFF2, which is a feeder-free culture media, I will explain in brief. And ReproXF, which is a new product launched this year. This is a completely xenofree culture media. This is Professor Shinya Yamanaka's article, The First Invention of iPS Cells. You can see the small name, Liprocells, in the material and method. He succeeded to establish the first human iPS cells by using our culture media. After that, a lot of Japanese ES and iPS researchers started to use our culture media. This is a new types of culture media, Lip4FF2. As you know, the most of culture media requires everyday operations from Monday to on Sunday. But our Liprof-FF2 requires only 3 days operation in a week. You can take a rest on Sunday and Saturday. Next is drug discovery business. We are providing three types of cells, cardiomyocyte, hepatocyte, and neuron, including Alzheimer's disease models. As you know, the cardiomyocyte and hepatocyte are very important cells for toxicity and other metastases. And neural cells is also important for CNS disease screenings. The most important thing is drug response, how to respond to drugs properly. And the next important thing is reproducibility. The first, I'd like to explain you the drug response by using the iPS cell-derived cardiomyocyte. And this slide shows how to measure the electrocardiograms. The thin layered beating cardiomyocyte is put on the microelectrodes to obtain the electrocardiograms. You can see the clear potassium and sodium channels in electrocardiograms. This is a lot-to-lot variations data. The right side is beating rate per minute in the 96-well plate. And the variation is very small, ranged from the 40 to 50 per minute. The standard deviation is only 3.3. And the left side is QT prolongations reproducibility by using the different lots. You can see the almost the same concentrations that start the QT prolongation. This our cardiomyocyte shows very reproducible results. And this is another assay systems, calcium imaging. The beating of cardiomyocyte can be detected by changing color like this one to obtain these types of signals. If the several compounds is added, this calcium imaging data can be changed. For example, the verapamil is added, the beating amplitude is decreased like this one. This is one of the summaries of the drug response by using MEA and the calcium imaging system. By combining these systems, we can obtain the consistent results. For example, by using the MEA QT prolongation and potassium and sodium channels amplitude. And by using calcium imaging, of course, calcium amplitude can be detected and the beating rate can be detected. Another product is iPS cell-derived hepatocyte. Our hepatocyte shows much higher purity, almost more than 95% without any selection. And expressing the many SIPs and almost comparable to a primary hepatocyte. First, this slide shows RNA expressions in reprohepato, which is an iPSC-derived hepatocyte. Number one is iPSC-derived hepatocyte. Number two is a comparison primary hepatocyte seeded after 48 hours. You can see the many SIPs, 3A4 and 2C9 and 2D6. Our reprohepato shows the comparable levels of the primary hepatocyte. And in addition, the other transporters, OATP1B1, shows similar expression levels compared to a primary hepatocyte. This is one of the assay results, the hepatotoxicity, by using the iPS-derived hepatocyte. The red circle shows IC50 by using the iPSC-derived hepatocyte. The number two is the primary hepatocyte. You can easily find the iPSC-derived hepatocyte shows a similar result compared to a primary hepatocyte. In addition, this is another assay system, the SIP induction by imaging systems. We tried three types of compounds, rifampicin, dexamethasone, and ketoconazole. With an increase in concentration of rifampicin and dexamethasone, CYP3A4 is induced like this one. And on the other hand, in the case of ketoconazole, CYP3A4 is inhibited. These results are consistent with the primary hepatocyte. According to these results, our hepatocyte primary, our iPSC-derived hepatocyte are comparable to primary hepatocyte. The third one, the last one, is neurons. We are providing three types of neurons, cholinergic, glutaminergic, and dopaminergic. This is not a movie, but this is calcium imaging. We can observe the spontaneous activity by using this system. And this is the last slide. We have succeeded to make Alzheimer's disease models jointly with Professor Norio Nakatsuji. And for example, presenilin-1 mutant is integrated into iPS cells and then differentiated into a neuron to make Alzheimer's disease models. This figure shows a comparison between the wild types and the mutant in expression levels of Alzheimer's amyloid beta 42. This figure shows this model shows typical Alzheimer's patient neurons. Recently, we launched a new business jointly with Takara Bio, Kitagawa-san, in collaboration to make a customized iPS cell. This is models. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Yokoyama. Next speaker is Dr. Masanori Kitagawa, General Manager of Biotechnology Research Laboratories, Takara Bio. He will talk about development of quality evaluation technology for pluripotent stem cells based on genetic information. Dr. Kitagawa, please.
Thank you, Chairman Professor Asada. And I appreciate Professor Nakatsuji and everyone who gave me this chance of presentation of our company and products. So first, I would like to talk about the Takara Bio. So you may know that Takara Bio is a biotechnology company in Japan. So in worldwide, the Clontech brand is more famous. We have a genetic engineering research business of supports the biotechnology research in worldwide. So we are the first company introduced the domestic restriction enzyme or PCR products in the Japanese market. So we have over 6,000 catalog products of life science research reagent in molecular and cell biology. This slide shows our business field. We have three business segments of Takara Bio. So not only the genetic engineering research field, but also we have a gene medicine segment. So we would like to contribute to human health through the development of revolutionary biotechnologies such as gene and cell therapy. Already, we have some clinical trials project of gene therapy. This is our growth business in the future. So you may image the gene therapy method is similar to the regeneration medical. So for this purpose, we construct two centers mainly. So one is a center for cell and gene therapy, named CCGT, and another is a Dragon Genomics Center. It's a large genome analysis center. So and And then I am working to join these facilities in our main research laboratories. So CCGT has a GMP grade producing pipeline, and Dragon Genomics has many kind of test menu for quality control of clinical materials. So by the way, this slide shows an example of a scheme of supporting the services for stem cell research. We think some steps are very important shown here. For example, the GMP grade GMP grade vector product for prep the iPS cells, and so under the quality evaluation of these ES or iPS cells by wide meaning genome analysis, including the transcriptome and the epigenetics using next-gen sequencers technologies, where for easier test, the qPCR is one of a good solution for it, the, we think. So the, this slide shows our Dragon Genomics' history of gene analysis business development. So we started participate the genome project of bacteria E. coli in 1989. Since 1989, so we have developed some advanced technologies for genome analysis and established big center for Dragon Genomics. Here, you can see the some MPSS machine. So this machine is a plot type of the Illumina sequences now. So we started this sequencing service from since the 2003. So then we introduced the first next generation sequencing made by 454 since 2006. Now we also have over the 10 Illumina sequencers and one PacBio sequencers. So we have new technologies introduced in Japan market. So since 2011, so Takara Bio has participated in this NEDO project in Nakatsuji group. We played a role in this group development of profiling the evaluation regions, evaluation regions for quality control of human pluripotent stem cells and developmental quality evaluation and control for the cell lines. And by the basis of the technology developed in the study of genetic engineering, those gene expression analysis and genome analysis, including SNPs, LOH, copy number variants, and epigenetics, then combined and integrated for them, we are aiming to make the profiling ES cells and IP cells. Then we will establish the quality management approach for them. To do so, I believe that there will be microarray and RT-qPCR and take advantage of advanced technologies such as next-generation sequencing technology. There is a problem experience and be able to demonstrate the progress. So here is some materials for we prepared with Kyoto University. So some human ES cell lines, Kyoto strains or Wisconsin strains. So some different passage numbers and retinoic acid stimulation differentiation. So this is a microarrays helical clustering ESL lines data. So we have today I don't have enough time, so precise detailed information. Please visit my poster session. So here I introduce the product by in this NEDO project, primary product. So this is a easy test tools for the pluripotency of the pluripotency stem cells kind. So here the one example of the previous I talk and show the materials. So Kyoto strains early versus late passage is a similar profile. So this late passage culture is also very stable and authorized culture method, we think. And differentiated stimulation culture is here shows a very variety change the gene expression. So this tool is very clearly show the pluripotency dense character here. So we test the some iPS strains, the very famous Yamanaka strains, and the third one is my own established strain. So here is compared to the Kyoto University strain 3. So very similar profile is you can see. So here is an example value of the correlation coefficient and the other Kyoto University strain or Wisconsin strains. So here this is one of the criteria I we think the this value, I think. So last I will show the strategy of the characterization of culture cells again. So they thought it would be necessary for evaluation to test the characterization of not only the pluripotent cell culture, but also differentiation ability of those. And the authorized method is important for testing the quality control and the evaluation of such cell culture. So our high performance technology for genome analysis can be applied to not only simple genome analysis, but also transcriptome and so on. So for these tests, including the check for the edited genome in the cell, Yokoyama-san said. So we would like to expand the fields of using advanced technology, for example, NGS or iHope. So that's good science for you, we hope. So thank you for your attention. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kitagawa. Next speaker is Dr. Masaaki Takahashi from Genentech Company. He will talk about stem cell characterization by using automated epigenetics system. Dr. Takahashi, please.
Thank you, Professor Sada. As a member of Kyoto University NEDO project, Genentech made two major contributions, namely, first is the development of automated system for epigenetics sample preparation, and second is the development of a new method for characterization of stem cells. I'm going to talk about briefly on these two subjects. The first is an automated system for epigenetic sample preparation having high performance software and hardware has been developed. You can see the overview of the instruments and the platform inside, and also a graphic user interface, which the operator just select the pictures stepwise to operate the whole entire procedure. The key technology which makes this automation possible is called MagTration technology, which consists of our plastic capillary and movable magnet attached to the capillary section of the pipette, which handle the magnetic bead. This is an automated epigenetics flow diagram. There are two different procedures. One is chromatin IP, and the other is methylated DNA IP. Each has a different and similar steps, and the circles these red circles indicate this step is automated by using the same instruments. This is a feature and benefit of automated epigenetic system. In particular, reproducibility is the most important benefit, we believe. To avoid variability from difference in skills between the operators and improve reproducibility and reliability of sample and data quality. And there are another benefit like easy optimization and walk away. This is an example of our reproducibility experiments, which is spike test using AutoMedip. It's carried out by Professor Stefan Beck in London University. As you can see, this blue, blue line indicate automated procedure, and red line is the manual. And you can see clearly there is a consistent recovery rate is obtained by using automated systems. Now I move to the next subject. As you know, the stem cells reprogramming and differentiation are entirely epigenetic changes. So we believe characterization of stem cells must be established based on epigenetic changes, and quality control should be established using epigenetic biomarkers. This is a current method for characterizing stem cells. The most widely used method is biochemical analysis, consists of microscopic observation and enzyme staining and antibody staining of surface antigens. These methods are very useful for large functional changes, but precise changes cannot be identified. Also, molecular biological analysis like comprehensive analysis using high-speed sequencer or gene expression analysis or RT-PCR could be possible, but each method has still some issues. So we believe there are no methods available for detecting precise epigenetic changes. We have developed a new method of stem cell characterization. And this is an example of ES cells characterizations. We have obtained the three different ES cells from Kyoto universities, namely E1 is early stage cultivation, E2 is a late stage cultivation, and E3 is differentiated. So we extract DNA from these cells and fragmented, and we have carried out MEDIP and HMEDIP simultaneously using an automated systems. HMEDIP is, as you know, the hydroxymethyl IP, which indicate the degree of demethylation. And the obtained sample is subject to methylation analysis by microarray and characterizations of ES cells by methylated and demethylated DNA patterns. So this is the result. As you can see in the upper column, there are many genes which shows almost identical patterns, either in MEDIP or HMEDIP. But there are some genes which show completely different patterns, like this, which suggest that these genes may be involved in epigenetic changes, in this case, aging and differentiations. We have done four repeated experiments to validate reproducibility of this method. And as you can see, we have obtained very good, high reproducible results. This is a summary. Automated system for epigenetic analysis has been developed, which installs high-performance software and new hardware. A new method of characterizing stem cells has been developed by using the automated epigenetic system, and MEDIP and HMEDIP of three different ES cells have been conducted by using the automated epigenetic system, followed by microarray analysis. Based on the results of microarray analysis of methylated genes, three different ES cells have been characterized by DNA methylation and demethylation patterns of probability values analyzed by using the algorithm. Also, it has been proved that the new method showed its high reproducibility and consistency. Further works are in progress by using the new method in order to establish the key epigenetic biomarkers for characterization of stem cells. This is our, we have done the news release jointly with Kyoto University and the government concerning the new method of epigenomic analysis by using an automated epigenetic system in early this year. Finally, we acknowledge the professors of Kyoto University, particularly Professor Nakatsuji, for his leadership and guidance of this project. And also we are grateful to the Japanese government for the funding of this project. And Diagenode, Belgian company, is our partner and distributors. We together developed these systems, and they are responsible for sales in Europe and the US. And finally, we thank to our parent company, PSS, and my colleagues in genetic companies. Our information regarding automated epigenetic system can be obtained through Diagenode website, but incidentally, Dr. Sharon Scovazzo, here, she's attending this meeting, And you can contact with her at the Kyoto University exhibition booth. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Takahashi. Last speaker is Dr. Masao Fukushima, Department Manager, Research Development, S-Bio Division, Sumitomo Bakelite Company. He will talk about qualitative measurement of ESL glycan profiles. Dr. Fukushima, please.
Thank you, Dr. Asada. Good afternoon. I'm glad to have a chance to introduce you about some of our work on ESL glycan profiling. Firstly, I'd like to talk about the background of our contribution to the regenerating medicine research shortly. This slide shows some of our products which are contributing to the research of regenerating medicine. There are three unique products shown here. StemFlow. The inner surface of this tube is treated with high density of unique polymer. And as a result, there is a no cell adhesion during the centrifugation. That is, we can get high recovery of even for the adherent cell, such as stem cell and iPS cell, ES cells. Secondary one is the prime surface related products. We use similar surface treatment technology on these products. Using prime surface plate, it is unique, easy to make the spheroid of ES cell and iPS cell without complicating handing drop method. These products are already used for the induction of ES cell, iPS cell, nerve stem cell differentiation, and drug design screening as three-dimensional model of the cells. Dr. Sasai of Riken reported the self-formation of optic cap and striatic neural retina from human ES cell using prime surface plate recently. The third one is blood-like kit. Simple and rapid sample preparation kit for glycan analysis from biological samples. Using this kit, it is possible to purify and labeling glycan from the crude sample, such as a glycoprotein, serum, cell, organ, plant, tissue, and so on, with a specific labeling reagents for following LSMS, MALD, TOFMAS, and HPLC analysis. It is well known that cell surface is covered with various kinds of glycan, and their works are important factor in the cell-to-cell interactions. This surface glycan pattern is also known to change during cell differentiation of stem cells. There are some reports the sugar chain works as a useful biomarker of the differentiation of stem cells, such as SSEA1, 3, 4, 5, TORA160, and TORA181. However, By the conventional method, glycan preparation and analysis are required for many steps and times. Usually, it requires several days from the enzyme digestion of glycan to the glycan to the labeling for purification purified glycans. Recently, we developed simple and rapid one-spot glycan purification and labeling kit. The commercial name of this product is Broad GlycoKit. It requires just 5 to 6 hours from purification to labeling steps. As one of the useful applications, we can use this kit for the analysis of glycan on ES cells and investigation of the glycan difference of undifferentiated cell and differentiated cells. Recent study on glycan have shown that the sugar chain of ES cells is similar to the of the cancer cells. For example, both ES cell and cancer cell Hyman-Nose type of glycan are the main structure or surface glycans. In contrast, in the somatic cell, complex and hybrid type of glycan are the main structures. Moreover, in the stem cell, Hyman-Nose type of glycans are considered to be the determinant of the cell adhesion and cell recognition. From this region, we decide to focus on the Hyman-Nose type of glycan in this study. First, we compared the major glycan of undifferentiated human ES cell and differentiated human ES cells to examine Hyman-Nose type of glycan expression level. We used three kinds of ES cells, which was distributed by Kyoto University. LC-MS analysis shown that the glycan expression level of M7 and M8 were discrete by differentiated interaction. On the contrary, glycan expression level of M5 and M9 were increased by differentiation induction. Next, to compare the minor glycan, we removed major glycan using Cohn-Ehrlichman columns. Here is the result. The particularly notable change were observed numbers 3, 6, and 9 of the minor glycans. I'm sorry to say that we can't disclose the detail of the minor glycan structure today, but one important thing is these major glycans were much phosphorylation sugar chain. Lewis X antigen is known as a glycan associating with the undifferentiated stem cells. Recent study has shown that alpha-1,3-fucose-transferase FUT10 gene was increasing in neural stem cell. In other words, FUT10 gene was more expressed in ES cell. It is supposed that FUT10 gene has the function to accelerate it and differentiate the state of the stem cell. These results suggest that different sugar chain expression level shown the cellular state. Let me summarize. We developed a broad glycan kit for the purification and labeling glycan of human stem cells. Hyman-Nose type and the minor glycan pattern were different between undifferentiated and differentiated human ES cells. Short staying, our study has provided glycan pattern were differentiated of ES cell state. For the future study, we are going to analyze the glycan pattern of stem cells. That could be useful for the discrimination of the differentiation propensity and quality control of ES cells. Finally, we'd like to thank Professor Dr. Nakatsuji and Dr. Suemori. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Kushima. Every speaker was finished. Is there any questions we can talk about? Sometimes for question. To go up to the stage, go up to the earphone, microphone. Sorry.
I'm sorry, it's a very simple question. We are following what is happening in Riken Institute with the regeneration of retina cells. And looking at the model that you show, I was wondering the prices of all those technology and what kind of possibilities we have of having from Argentina, in which we want to make an institution for an institute of developing stem cells for the recovery of the acuity of the vision, if there is any chance of preparing a kind of convene or approach with you, because the people of the university and the people of the societies, the scientific societies, are absolutely interested, but we are very far away about the technology that we need and what it costs. So the idea is to ask if you can lead us and be our advisors in the organization of something that can cooperate with your RIKEN works. The people of RIKEN was 2 months ago in Buenos Aires, and everybody was crazy about what is happening there. We want to approach.
Yeah, for our group here, I can only comment about the future perspective of the cost of those retina treatment. But retina treatment is relatively fortunate that I already said it needs only 10 to 50 cells, especially small number. So probably with currently available production system, one production could produce, for example, 100 cell number enough for treating 100 patients. And I think the currently clinical trial of ACT and Pfizer aiming at that way. So select one single cell line, they are using ESL line, could be in the future, IBS, but select the best quality cell line and mass culture, mass produce retinal pigmented cells and divide into the dosage for the transplantation, a package, and maybe freeze and distribute worldwide. So that way, probably the cost could be reduced to the affordable level. So that's kind of thing. And differentiation protocol should be, rather than using cytokines, probably replacing it by small compound, and cost may be 100s or something lower. So in this way, after now, this current stage is make first trial of the first evidence of cure or treating the disease. Then next stage is how to make that available to many patients.
And in that way, many sectors must work together, and we are working for that kind of mass production and using chemical compound.
So you think that maybe from far away, in a little scale, we can help with a model like this kind of glycan matrix that you show last. Maybe there is a possibility, because what you are talking is not absolutely expensive or impossible to participate. Do you think that we can prepare a model of sharing experiences between societies and helping from far away in the work that you are developing?
Our part is talking about production and the cost reduction, and the clinical sector must think of that way. Yeah.
Thank you. Is there any questions? Okay. Thank you for attending for our symposium. Thank you very much. One more, we have a booth for ICEMS and also Nissan Chemicals next door. Please visit our booth for more discussion. Thank you very much.